no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I
We first met at my house. I was sick one day and my good friend Ari decided to bring me soup, and she invited Jake along to come. And so everyone came over to my house and we hung out, and he made me soup and tea, and we were talking about God and life, and then me and Ari fell asleep and him and Sarah just continued to talk the night away. And I thought he was such a cool guy though when I first met him. I thought he was really cool.
It was about, I don't know, maybe 8 months after that. We hadn't seen each other. It was the first time we ever met. And then the same friend that wanted to bring her soup when she was sick told me that it was her birthday and she wanted to throw her a birthday party. So I helped Ari throw a birthday party for her. And then after that, we started hanging out. And about, what, 8 months into hanging out?
Okay. Yeah.
I started to like her. And so I asked her out on a date.
Felt it first when I was younger. A strange connection to the light.
I started to like her and I went to the tabernacle with her. This thing, it was like a historical reenactment of the tabernacle. After that, I was in the car with her and I was determined to ask her out on a date.
Yeah, so we were sitting in the car together and He's definitely acting like he wants to tell me something that he's been thinking about for a while. So you bang on the steering wheel, and I just thought like, oh, what's wrong? You know, like, it's okay. And
I was really scared.
Yeah. And he's like, oh, I've been wanting to ask you out on a date for a while, and I didn't say yes right away because I felt like I had to go away and think about it and pray about it, because I knew that if we were going to start dating, things were going to be a lot different and our friendship was going to be different. And could this be someone that I could marry in the future? I just had all these thoughts in my head. And after thinking about it for a couple of days, I called him back and I said, I'd love to go on a date with you. And went on from there.
Was taken. Not everything is lost. Not everything is lost. No. But your love, the only thing that matters is your love, that's all I have to give.
We were doing a lot of worship and praising God and just having a normal youth group session. And then after worship, he decides to get up and he does a little beatboxing in the in the microphone. And everyone got a kick out of it. Everyone thought it was so cool. I was like, oh my gosh, I had no idea
that
he could do that, you know? And me and Ari were having fun because she was sitting like right next to me. And then he started praying for me. He started praying for just my future, my life, and my friends, and my family, and just having a good year being 20, because I was turning 20 at the time. Mm-hmm. And then he started to pray for my husband, which I just, you know, no one had ever done for me before in that amount of people. And so I just felt like, oh my gosh, that's just so sweet, you know? I felt like, how touching, how caring, you know? That's really precious, and mm-hmm. I really appreciated it. It was really cool.
Yeah, I don't even remember praying about that, so I must have been inspired.
Oh yeah, people around me were like, "It's really would he? Like, does he know her that well?" You know. But yeah, I really appreciate it, regardless of what anyone else thought. I thought it was really nice. Yeah.
So.
Never thought that he would, you know, be my fiance or anything. I just taking it as is, you know.
So after we became boyfriend and girlfriend, we waited for like 2 weeks and we hadn't kissed or anything. And then we went to my old neighborhood where I grew up and went to a tree fort that I made. And we had our first kiss in a tree fort overlooking trestles, and it was just incredible. We have dated now for about 2.5 years. And then I was trying to propose. And so I brought her up to this place called The Compass. It's in Talega and it's up in the hills. And I wanted to bring you up there because that's where you go to meet with God and pray and listen to worship music. So I wanted you to be closer to God up there. And it was just cool to look over San Clemente and see the ocean and just everything that I've grown up with. And so I was so scared, you know. I don't know if she was expecting it. And it took me about 15 minutes to just get down on my knee while we were standing up there. I don't know why, it's not that the ground's not that far away, you know. It's just so scary. Wasn't sure if it was the right time or like the right weather. I was thinking about way too many things at once. And so finally just got down on one knee, and you were very supportive because I was so scared. And she gave me a hug and a kiss. And then I asked her to marry me. When she said yes, I had a fake ring because it was April Fool's Day. And so I brought the fake ring out. And she goes, oh, because it didn't look anything like the one that we were like looking at. And then I was so scared because I didn't want to hurt her feelings or anything. And so I just took the ring and I go, that's the fake one. And I go, phew. And I just fling it into the bushes. And she was so confused. She's like, what? Like, what just happened? Like, what? Where is the ring? And I go, this is the real one. This is the real one. She's like, trying to like go get the fake one out of the bushes. I was like, wait, no, stay here. And I had the ring wrapped in the cloth that we had that symbolized Jesus' sacrifice for us, and that we got from the tabernacle the day I first asked her out on a date.
When he got down on one knee, I got so nervous. My heart just started pounding. And I could tell maybe he was a little scared too, but it was perfect because I felt comfortable at the same time. And so, yeah, he asked me to marry him, and I said yes, of course. And he pulls out the little fake ring, and he just tosses it aside. Like a fly went by. It was like, oh, what was that? Like, it was shiny, but what was that for? You know, it was so cute because you were still yourself, you know, when you tossed it in the bushes, like, it didn't matter.
Oh, man.
Yeah, and I wanted to go look for it, but it is still up in those hills. We still left our mark up there. But, yeah, then he brought out this one, and it was wrapped in that cloth from the tabernacle, and something that we've been keeping forever, and then he pulled it out, and it was just, oh, sparkling so much, and it was beautiful, gorgeous, and I just couldn't wait for him to put it on my finger. And
man.